Hey, what's up guys? I'm going to be on my way to the range to finally get the Glock 17 out. But quickly, before I leave, I wanted to show you Philster's holster, Philly EDC's holster that he made for me, and what it looks like on me. Now, this is not the evaluation. I've been wearing it, so I just want to kind of show it to you on me for now. And the holster works out really good. Full combat grip, one-handed reholstering, no problem. Retention, awesome. But the full combat grip is where it's at. That's what I really like about this. And the one-handed reholstering. Now, as you can see, it's, you know, it's pretty slim. Contours to the body decently. But the one thing about this kind of holster, it's, you know, when the summertime comes, something like this is going to be hard to conceal underneath a t-shirt. Okay? It prints pretty bad. And that's not the fault of this holster. This is a Glock 17 full-size gun. Full-size grip, four-inch whatever barrel. That's gonna be hard to conceal underneath a t-shirt, and I wouldn't carry this, in the summertime anyways. What I carry is my 340 M&P J-frame. But something like this, I would wear in the fall, winter, spring, what have you, underneath a jacket or a vest. And let me put on this. I'm wearing a gun vest. And show you. So if you wore it like this, it conceals pretty well. So you would have to wear this under a jacket or something. So some people are asking me, what about inside the waistband? You know, doing this inside a waistband. I'm not really sure about that yet. I have not done it, but I will try it. But I'm not really sure if this is going to work out inside the waistband. But let's see. Well, let's see. Let's see what happens. So. Okay, let's get to the range anyways. So again, this is not the evaluation. Give me another week, and I'll do an evaluation on the holster. All right, let's go. Hey, what's up, guys? Going off to the range, and like I said, I'm going to be doing a full review on Philly EDC's holster in a week or so. I'm wearing it right now, and it is printing underneath the t-shirt because it's kind of warm today. It's like, look at that, 79 degrees already, and it's 7 o'clock at night. So it's pretty warm out. Anyways, we're gonna do this first time Glock 17 test fire, and I'm hopefully it's gonna work fine because it's a Gen 4, and some people have kind of commented that there are some issues with the Gen 4, but I don't think there will be, but we'll find out. I also brought my 340 M&P, which is my CCW, and that's the thing I carry with me all the time, and you see it in all my videos because it's my everyday carry. It's always on me, and I stay consistent. I want to have it on me, so we're gonna do some test firing with that, practicing with that. So I'm hoping I'll be able to set up my iPhone in the range, but we'll find out if I can in a few minutes. But if I can't, oh well, we'll just recap. I'll come out and tell you what happened. All right, be right back. Hey, what's up guys? Just left the range and I'm happy to report that the Glock 17 worked flawlessly, but it did have some issues with locking back on the last round. That was my fault. I recognize that because every time it did that, I looked at my grip and for some reason my freaking thumb was pressing down on the slide stop. So I guess I got to modify my grip a little bit. I don't know if it's because of just shooting 1911s for so long or what was going on with me, because that was really bizarre. This never really happened to me before. Maybe it's because I'm getting older, but other than that, I use all different types of ammunition through it and no failure to feeds at all. No issues. Again, except for my operator error of, pressing down on that slide stop so it wouldn't lock back on the last round. So that's no biggie. You just have to be cognizant of that. Set some interesting characters at the range as usual. I don't know, we were talking about 5.7. Some guy was carrying a 5.7, but he wasn't allowed to shoot it at this range. But he had one, and he kept saying that how awesome it was. And I'm like, But anyways, so let me get home. We'll talk about the Glock 17 a little more. All right, I'm home. It's late at night. I actually spent some after hours at the range, just hanging out with a bunch of the guys, shooting the breeze, helping them set up for the IDPA match for the weekend. And a lot of the guys had to ask me, is that a Edgar Allan Poe holster? You know, that Edgar Allan Poe, the poem, The Raven. Anyways, they thought it was one of those holsters, and they're like, we got to check this thing out. So I had to take it off and show them this holster. They were very, very impressed. And these guys all run Glocks, whether it be a 21 or a 17. And they're always looking for new Kydex gear for IDPA. And I let them check this thing out, and they were very impressed with it. So I had to tell them it's a Philly EDC product, Filster.com. I had to spell it out for them because they had no clue what I was trying to tell them. So we'll see, They liked it a lot, and I like the holster. But again, I'll do the evaluation in about another week. Give me another week with this thing. Yeah, pretty nice. So Glock 17 worked out really well. I want to let you know that I did not do anything to this Glock 17 before I went to the range. I didn't take it apart and clean it or anything. I left it as is, didn't even put any lube, no oil in it, and I just left the copper grease in there and shot with it. Nothing happened except for operator error. The slide failed to lock back on the last round because of my grip, I guess. I don't know what I was doing, but I recognized that. My grip was pushing down on that slide stop, so it wasn't locking back sometimes. It happened like 3 times, actually. Other than that, I used a 124 grain and 115 grain, full metal jacket with no issues, no failure to feeds or anything. I did some 147 grain, no issues. Those are HST rounds, and no issues. Gold dot, no issues. That was a 115 grain standard. So it's a Glock. It works. Let's check out what's inside. So as you can see, I left the copper grease in there, and it is dirty inside, so I'm contemplating, should I clean this thing, or should I just leave it alone until the next range visit? What should I do? And there's barrel, yeah, it's pretty dirty. But anyways, I left the copper grease on there, and you're supposed to leave that stuff on there, right? That's what I was told a long time ago, back in the day. So that grease is supposed to assist in the break-in process, and I was always told never to touch that in the first, couple 500 rounds or whatever. But I don't know, what do you guys think about that, the copper stuff? Do I just leave it there, clean this bad boy, or just leave it? I mean, these things can run dirty, and they're very simple to take apart. Now here is my J-frame. I got to clean this baby up, and I thought my iPhone was rolling when I was shooting 357 Magnum out of this damn thing, but it wasn't. So I don't have the footage for that, but I'm not going to lie, as I said in my past videos, 357 Magnum out of this thing right here is brutal. And tonight, I don't know what was wrong with me, I wasn't shooting that great with 357 Magnum coming out of there. It hurt. And the groups were not tight at all. But when I used 38 Special Plus P 110 grain by Corban DPX. I get groups like that. They're so tight. So I guess that's just telling me something. Stick with the 38 Special Plus P DPX Corbans. But I don't know. Maybe next time I go to the range, I'll try the 357 Magnum again and make sure my freaking iPhone's recording. But anyways, it's getting late at night. I'm going to go to bed. Maybe clean these up tomorrow. So as always, guys, leave some comments. But stay safe and check 360 often. Later.